The Hollywood sign, maybe the most famous and iconic signs ever built. 9 letters, each towering 50 feet tall, angled to follow the natural curvature of the hillside for a total of 450 feet. The Hollywood sign is perfectly perched at the summit of Mount Lee, overlooking the community of Hollywood and the Los Angeles Basin, where many dreams are born and many die. Under the shadow of this sign can be found the most talented artists, storytellers, and visionaries in the world, living, working, and playing. The story of the sign goes back 100 years, when Hollywood was nothing more than a grove of orange and lemon trees. For 100 years, the Hollywood sign has defied all odds and endured the tests of time, forever cementing its legacy in our culture. To all who come here seeking fame and fortune, it is a symbol of hope, luck, and the belief in oneself. So here's to you, the Hollywood sign. Happy 100th birthday from all of us. Thank you.
Advised. used to float, now I just fall down. I used to know, but I'm not sure now what I was made for. What was I made for? Taking a drive, I was an ideal, not so alive. Turns out I'm not real, just something you paid for. What was I made for?
Thank you. Wow!
It was amazing. Can't wait to see the footage.
Yeah, I know. We got some great shots.
Flying through the trees felt like we were part of a forest.
It was like you're a bird. Such a joy to fly.
Hey guys, let's move to the next one.
The past few years have been incredible. As a travel filmmaker, I've had the opportunity to exchange smiles and stories with people from every corner of the world. All it takes is one fleeting moment, a conversation, a smile, or even a view to change your perspective on everything. That's why I love drones so much. As a creator, the ability to tell my story from a totally new perspective is the most grounding experience. I've learned to never leave my house without a drone. That way, I'm able to capture each precious moment in the water lens. Behind each of these shots is a story in a moment frozen in time. I'm so glad I was able to share the joy these experiences brought me with you. Thanks for watching.
Advised. Da quando gli uomini camminano sulla terra, si sono chiesti come volare. Abbiamo trascorso più di un decennio a creare strumenti per i sognatori. Ora stiamo facendo un passo avanti con un'esperienza immersiva diversa da qualsiasi altra.
Thank you. Da molto tempo ho quest'idea. Voglio creare qualcosa di veramente unico. Qualcosa di affascinante, come un bellissimo film. E quindi inizio a farlo. Pianifico, sogno, realizzo, fallisco. Fallisco di nuovo. Quindi modifico, rielaboro, lavoro, lavoro, lavoro fino a quando... è finito. Ora guardo ciò che ho realizzato e non è eccezionale. Non è affascinante, non è nemmeno vicino a quello che intendevo realizzare inizialmente. Avrebbe potuto essere migliore. Deve essere migliore. Mi chiedo se ho sprecato il mio tempo. Ma poi mi ricordo... ricordo che i più grandi artisti non realizzano un capolavoro al primo tentativo, e nemmeno al 50°. Ricordo che la creatività non riguarda solo il processo di creazione di qualcosa, ma si tratta di collaborare, creare sinergie. Si tratta di affinare le proprie capacità con ogni lavoro, a poco, perfezionandosi nel proprio mestiere. Quindi quando mi ritrovo a criticare il mio stesso lavoro o la mia mancanza di progressi, ricordo a me stesso che questo è un lungo processo di evoluzione. Se manco di esperienza o di capacità, posso compensare lavorando duramente. Ma soprattutto, ricordo a me stesso che smettere non è un'opzione e che non sto andando da nessun'altra parte, se non in alto.
Like a sound you hear that lingers in your ear. here, but you can't forget from sundown to sunset. Nah, nah. It's all in the air, you hear it everywhere. No matter what you do, it's gonna grab a hold on you. California soul. Your feet and you got to move, cause it's really such a groove now. Uh-huh. It's a brand new kind of thinking in your mind, and you can't go wrong, cause you're grooving all day long. California soul.
Journal, day 6. I'm surprised I've made it 6 days. I thought for sure I would have been dead by the second. But I know that even if I prolonged it, death is still coming for me in this wilderness. No food, no water, no hope for escape. It wasn't supposed to be like this. Just a simple trip. But how could I have known? My body is depleted of all energy. there is nothing left. I try to keep going, but I just can't do it anymore. Then I see it. My way out. We'll take all that I have, but I could finally escape this place. Day 7. I'm home.